Ladies and gentlemen, happy Friday. I hope you guys are excited for a fantastic weekend. We are live from Columbus, Ohio at the MLG.TV Arena, and this weekend we have six incredible teams from around the world competing for the first title of the Joint Dota MLG Pro League Champion. To tell us more about the tournament, let's send it up to two of our casters for the weekend. We got Toby with the Capitalist.
Thank you very much, Chris. Yes, I'm Tubby One, joined by the Capitals. We're going to be here all weekend long, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, to do our first LAN final for the Joint Dota MLG Pro League. Should be a cracker, Cap.
Yeah, it's absolutely amazing. I think that this is one of the most interesting tournaments out there. I mean, because the teams that are coming into this all have such a big opportunity coming into this, right? Amazing teams that, like, such as Evil Geniuses, who already established themselves, and lower tier teams like Falcon Bears, who are just now coming up. And it's made even more interesting, right, by that tournament format.
Yeah, it's one of the roughest tournament formats we could come up with, just because we're just sadistic in this kind of way, where we try and make the teams play for every single win. Every single game in the round robin means so much. Six teams play each other, everyone plays everyone. Only the top four will advance through, but the positioning is what's the critical point.
Yeah, the best of one round robin basically determines, there's so much importance in this round robin as opposed to every other tournament, where this round robin actually determines your positioning in the playoffs so much more than every other one. First place gets themselves into the finals. Second place, semifinals, and then third and fourth place into the one quarterfinal, and the other two, they're out.
Yeah, that's right, and that's not the position you want to be in, especially when we've got so much prize money up for grabs, as we've managed to get over $85,000. Because you can continue to raise this prize pool up even higher by buying the tickets inside the Dota 2 client, and of course you can support the live stream by getting out there on your social network, spamming it all out, and let everyone know about mlg.tv/joindota, which is where you can find the English live stream. We've got a whole bunch of different languages as well, but yeah, it's a huge amount of prize money, and also playing for the pole position. That's what you're really searching for. This close to the TI invites, it's a critical time.
Yeah, absolutely. A lot of money on the line, and so close to the TI, this tournament is going to mean a lot to many of these teams. Evil Geniuses maybe have already cemented themselves, but everyone else is definitely a huge bumper. If they can actually get themselves into the finals, it's a huge saying to going into TI.
But well, let's see what games we've got coming up today, Cap, because in today, we do have a short day today, so not too long. We've only got six games for your schedule. We start a little bit later, so everyone had time to get home from work and come down to this wonderful arena in Ohio. We'll be kicking off with Team Empire versus MVP Phoenix. MVP Phoenix being really a bit of a superstar team coming out ever since what happened to TI4. Everyone's like, hey, these guys are actually quite good, and they have been having some decent performances. Now they're going to have to try it up against Team Empire.
Yeah, with a newer roster, a lot of question marks there, and a lot more question marks for our second match, which is going to be Ninjas in Pajamas versus Balkan Bears Corleone. Balkan Bears, of course, this is their first LAN. Talking to the guys earlier, they sound really excited, but it is going to be their first performance on a LAN. And then our third match, Toby, that is going to be the most highly anticipated match of the night, easily. Team Empire versus Evil Geniuses, top two favorites for this tournament.
Yeah, and we can get even more excited about that one, depending on how Team Empire is going to play in this first series. So keep your eyes peeled for that one. MVP Phoenix versus BBC will also wrap up our first four games. And then we go into the doubleheader for the Peruvian fans out there. Not today, we're playing up against EG as well as NIP. It's a rough time for them. They're also playing both the games. It's the only doubleheader we've got for the whole tournament format, primarily because they're coming in a little bit later on their flights, so we'll push them to the end of the day. But of course, we want to actually pick apart these teams, see who is really going to be competing here at the Joint Dota MLG Pro League. And to do that, we'll head down to our analysis desk, where we have Zoe leading the charge, Nahaz on stats, and Blitz just being him.
Thank you so much, guys. We are here on the desk, and of course, we also want to welcome you to our panel. Blitz is also going to be casting some of the games, so he's not going to join us here for the whole entirety of the tournament. And of course, we have Nahaz, who's hopefully not leaving me, and he will provide you with good insight and stats. And before we're going to head into the first game of the night, we want to actually take a look at all those teams which will be playing throughout the next 3 days. And we're going to start with a team which almost does not need an introduction. They are playing on home turf, so let's take a look at EG. Evil Geniuses coming here with Universe, PPD, Sumail, AUI 2000, as well as Fear. And what is there to say about those guys? They have been on top of their game as of late. They have been winning, they have been placing first, but what else can we say?
Yeah, I mean, as you can probably tell by the crowd reaction, these guys are the men right now in Pro Dota 2. If TI5 started tomorrow, I think most people would have EG as the favorites to win that tournament, and they're definitely the favorites this weekend. They're coming off a huge win, obviously, at DAC 2 months ago. Since TI4, they have competed in 7 LAN events, and they've won 4 of them. And they finished second in another to the only other team that's won 4 LANs, and that's Vici Gaming. So these guys have dominated. They are the top team KDA in 6.83. They're 3.72. That would be impressive for an individual player, much less a team. And Fear and Sumo, the only two of the only 4 players to average 600 gold per minute per more in matches since that point. So this team has looked amazing.
Yeah, and I think EG is going to be the team that everybody looks to have their target on. This is a team that if you have an impressive performance against, you know that it means something, even in the best of one format. So if any team is going to bring out any sort of brilliant strategies or any sort of pocket strategies, you're going to see it used against EG.
All right. So the next team we are going to take a look at are the guys from South America, the Peruvian team, and Not Today, which will be playing the last 2 days of the day. They're coming with Rowlers, Mystico, Fan, Smash, as well as Ifrit. And I would say it's... I'm actually going to go for it. I think they're the most versatile team we actually even have here, if you just look at what the players are able to play, not only in terms of hero, but in terms of the positions.
Yeah, typically you'll see one player play one lane, and at most maybe you'll see him play another one. But these guys, 1 through 3, they're willing to switch it up, even 4 and 5. They're willing to give themselves up. Like Smash will play the mid, he'll play the carry, and sometimes he'll even play the offlane, which is something you really typically don't see if you're 1 or 2 player. And so when you do that, you have a lot of trust in your team. You're essentially saying, if I'm playing the offlane, I'll trust that you'll play one of the other 2 cores just as well as I would.
Yeah, so they're definitely a team to look out for. Now, the next one we're going to see are our representatives from the C region. I'm talking about MVP Phoenix. They're coming with Warnuts, March, Febby, KP, and QO. And, they only just recently, 2 months ago, after the performance of the DAC, they kind of changed their roster. They only have March and QO remaining from the old roster. But what can you tell us about the rest of the team here?
Yeah, this is a talented team. Febby was the previous captain for Poker Face, who actually did quite well for themselves. Warnuts is a player from Hot 6 CSW, or KP is a player from, he was the former mid for CSW, which was a really talented Australian team as well. So in terms of pure talent, these guys have it. After the disappointing performance at DAC, they thought to themselves, okay, we have to have some sort of change in our roster, and this is what they came up with. And I'm interested to see, in a best of one format especially, how they're going to perform.
And next up, we're going to take a look at the Balkan Bears Corleone, and they unfortunately are joining us with a stand-in. However, it's not just any stand-in, it's actually someone who has quite a big name. I'm talking about Weeha, and he will be joining Masakari and Yapsar, as well as Levy and Miracle for this lovely match, and for all those matches, actually. And I mean, yeah, as I just said, Weeha is standing in for Pedrinho. However, Weeha did actually play with him before. He was, I believe, even one of the founding members of that team, and he's definitely a big name out there, and I'm pretty sure that's going to work out fairly well with them.
Yeah, I think so. BBC is, despite being probably the least well-known of the big-name European teams, this team 2-0'd Alliance, Tinker, and Polar to get here to Columbus. So they're capable of putting up results against very, very good competition. They split a series with Ninjas in Pajamas early this week. And Weeha, as you said, he is just an incredibly explosive player. One of only 4 players in this patch average over 9 kills per match in professional play. He's just a ridiculous snowball player. And the other thing about this team, they draft with absolutely no fear. I mean, we've seen them recently first picking the Brood Mother. Unfortunately, their Brood player isn't here this weekend, so we're probably going to see something else. But in a best of one series, this is the kind of team that has so much upset potential.
And they have good stats on that Brood Mother too. let me tell you that. So last but not least, we have Team Empire for you. And they will be joining us here with the roster, as we see here. Aloha Dance, Silent, Always Wanna Fight, Resolution, and as a standing for Yoki, we have Phonic joining you. And Phonic is a top player, definitely, but do you feel like it's gonna work out for them, as Yoki was a pretty integral part of the team as a drafter, as well as the team, like the in-game shot caller, or whatever you wanna call it?
Yeah, I mean, Funix certainly one of the elder statesmen of the game. And I mean, you've got two players on this team with over 500 career wins, including Silent, who we'll talk about in a bit. But Empire has probably done enough alongside EG to secure themselves a direct invite to TI5. They have the third most total wins in this patch at 67. There are 18 different teams that have played 80 games or more in this patch, and they have the second highest winning percentage behind only Vici Gaming. So this is a team that they put up the results, and they've also done something at LANs as well. They won Star Series 11 earlier this year, finished second at Major All-Stars earlier this month. So this is a team with a heck of a resume. However, they are only 13-18 in the last 30 days in professional play. They played some good competition, but these players have to be thinking about last year at this time. Empire looked really good. They looked in position to contend at TI. They kind of lost their mojo at around this time of the year, and they never really got it back. So I think this is a very important tournament for Empire momentum-wise.
Yeah, and like you said about Yoki, that's the guy who drafts for them. He's their offlane player, which is an integral role. And he's also their drafter. He's their in-game captain.
Their captain, yeah.
And so when you have a player like that that's missing, you just lose so many intangibles. Obviously, Funnik isn't a slouch. He was a TI caliber player. He got to the finals of TI3 against Alliance, did quite well for himself throughout the year. And so in terms of pure skill, maybe you don't lose out too much. But when it comes to actual things like who's going to be drafting for them, who's going to have the strategies prepared for them, it's not going to be him.
Yeah, and I mean, Funnik did play with most of those guys prior as well. I mean, they used to be in the same team, or some of them anyway. So yeah, we'll see how that's going to work out for them. And of course, actually, Empire wasn't our last team we're going to present to you. We have the Swedish team, Ninjas in Pyjamas. We want to show you with Jonas Somfan, Hanskin, Limp, Sealkid, and of course also Era. Probably the face of the team. I mean, everyone knows Era from Fnatic, and now he once more surrounded himself with ex-HOM players to participate in the Dota scene once more. Ninjas in Pyjamas, a big name in the Counter-Strike scene, and now they're also branched into Dota.
Yeah, and Era really has been one of the strongest individual players of this patch. If you look at individual KAD kills plus assists over death, Era is right just barely under 5, that second overall behind only Fear. He's been incredibly consistent in these matches, and we just got done with March Madness in college basketball. I want to talk this weekend about May Madness, because we are, if last year is any indication, we're right around 3 or 4 weeks before you're going to see TI bids go out. And in that regard, NIP, I think, is your proverbial bubble team. They've done enough to get themselves on the radar, but they have the second most total wins in 6.83. And I really feel like if they had a big LAN win on their resume, particularly over teams like Empire, over teams like EG, that might be enough to catapult them up into that automatic bid status. So of all the six teams playing, I think you could make an argument that Ninjas in Pyjamas might have the most to gain this weekend.
So now we know all the teams which will be participating, and you see there's a lot on the line for them. They want to have the exposure, they want to like get themselves out there and make themselves visible for something like TI. And well, before we kick off with the games, we actually want to take a look at the streaming platforms. Where can you watch this tournament? And the answer is right here on your screens. MLG.tv is one place where you can watch it, but of course you can also just head over to Xbox 360, Xbox One. You can watch it on your tablets, you can watch it on your mobile phones, as well as on Roku. So there's plenty of opportunities to not miss a single second of this lovely tournament. And before we kick things off with the first game tonight, we're actually going to head into a very quick commercial break. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.